Hi everyone! Today we're going to talk about NX and specifically how NX will make your Vite project fly. I am Katerina Skroumpelou. I'm a senior engineer at NX, a Google developer expert for Angular and Google Maps, a Women Tech Makers ambassador, a speaker, an instructor. I really, really like cats, and you can follow me at cybercity or cyber.city. So, what is NX? NX is not just another build system. NX will make your CI faster. I will assume that most of you know what NX is, more or less, so I will not bore you with the details. What I will do is that I will show you an amazing demo on Stack Blitz that you can try right now at home. But just to be sure, NX offers two main pillars. The NX Cloud, which ensures that you can scale your projects, you can replay your tasks and make everything fast, and NX plugins through the NX CLI, no less, that provide automation, automatic migrations, and can help with code maintenance. So let's jump to the demo. You were just going to start with a Stack Blitz project. You can use a React or a Vue or whatever you want because NX plugins support all. We're going to start with a TypeScript React project. We are going to make a GitHub repository out of it. We are going to use the amazing npx nx init command to add nx to our new React Vite application. So npx nx latest init, and it's going to ask us a few questions to set up our new nx workspace. First, it's going to ask which of the following scripts are cacheable. That means produce the same output given the same input. The build and the lint tasks are usually cacheable. Does the build script create any outputs? Sure, they put it inside this. Does the lint script create any outputs? I don't know, I will leave it blank. And do you like to enable remote caching to make your builds faster? Yes, of course, this is NX Cloud. And it's going to ask us if we want to add some NX plugins. We're going to add ESLint and Vite plugins in order to take advantage of what NX offers. And yes, we want to start using NX in our package.json scripts. Now that it has generated and installed everything, it says that we have to commit and push our changes because our NX workspace, NX Cloud workspace is ready. We have to commit and push our changes and create a pull request for the changes. Now that I have added and pushed everything, I can go back to the NX Cloud link. Here I can connect a GitHub repository. I can add it to an existing organization. It doesn't matter at the moment. And I just click connect workspace. Right now, we don't have any runs that are run and no CI pipeline executions. If I run the npx nx run many build command, it will run the build command for my Vite project. Once these are finished, I can go back to my runs and see my runs in the show all runs page. I can go back to my terminal and click on the cloud.nx.app link, and it will take me to my run on NX Cloud, and I can see it there and see all the outputs from each command. Now you can see if we go on GitHub, you can see that adding NX just makes minimum changes to your workspace. It just adds some new packages in package.json, just changes the package.json scripts for build and serve. And it also adds an nx.json file with some configurations for NX. It's not intrusive. It doesn't change anything on your application. Just adds a config file and changes some things in your package.json. Now, let's see how you can set up continuous integration in your newly created Vite and NX workspace. So we can go ahead and set up CI by running this generator, npx nx generate CI workflow. What is our target CI provider? It's GitHub. What should we name our workflow? Let's say CI. And you see it did add a CI workflow inside our GitHub folder, which will run a command that's npx nx affected and target lint test build. We don't have any tests at the moment, and the affected means that nx affected only runs tasks that have been affected by the changes. We cross out the test and we're just going to push our changes. Once our changes are pushed, GitHub already has this action set up that it's already running, and we can see that it's running all the steps in that workflow. So if we go back to our workspace and make a new change, let's first create a pull request and let's make a small change to our app.tsx. Now, once our change is pushed, we can go on GitHub and open a new pull request for this change. And soon enough, the NX Cloud report will appear here, and I can click the click to track progress button, which is going to take me on NX Cloud where I can see my workflow being in progress. And here I can actually see what the agents are and what tasks are being run. I can already see that it's spinning up two agents because it wants to run the build and the lint tasks in parallel in these two agents that I have. And I can granularly see what the build and the lint look like, how long they take, and everything is available on NX Cloud to look at. Now, let's take a look at the magic of affected. In my existing NX workspace, which is just a Vite app, I generated a new Vite React TypeScript app using the Vite CLI. And I just added it inside an apps folder inside my existing Vite repository. This app just has one component named app2. In package.json, what I added was the workspaces attribute. Now, if I run nx graph, the command nx graph, I can see the two projects that are in my nx workspace. What my goal is now is to create a change in my new application to see how the affected command works. I commit my change and I create a new PR with this change. So now on NX Cloud, the command is NX affected with target lint and build. And because I only made changes in this new project, you will see that it's only building and linting this new project, the React-TS project, and it's not building the other project or linting the other project at all. What we're going to do now is we're going to go on our main app.tsx and import the app2. From our other application. Now, if I run NX graph again and click show all projects, we are going to see that our main project is dependent on the React.ts project because it's importing it. Now, let's push our changes and make a new PR with making a change again to the React.ts project. After we've made the changes and we've pushed them to just the new application and we create the new pull request, we're waiting to see what NX Cloud says and how NX will treat these new changes. And we see that now it's running four tasks instead of two. Before, it's only run two tasks because only the new application was affected. But now, because the old application, the main application, depends on the new application, it has to rerun, rebuild, and relint actually the main application as well. So it's running four tasks distributed on two agents. One agent is running the build for the one application. The other agent is running the linting, the build, and the test, the lint of the other application as well. So you can see how easy it is, after all, to add NX to your Vite project. You can just do npx NX init and it will work. What's more, NX loves the OSS community and the OSS community loves NX. So what are you waiting for? You can find NX at NX Dev Tools on X or nx.dev or nx.app. And you can find me at CyberCity or cyber.city. See you soon.